It was only a matter of time before escalation would come, and now this escalation cost a militant Antifa member his life. Before we jump into the news, guys, make sure to drop a like on this video and share it around. It helps the channel to grow and rank better in terms of search and recommendations. Today we have the result of the constant, deliberate rhetoric from the left. A rifle-armed 69-year-old man named Willem van Spronsen from Vashon Islands attacked an immigration center in Tacoma, Washington. The guy carried incendiary devices that were thrown at large propane tanks, attempting to set them on fire and making them explode. While throwing those devices, he successfully set one vehicle on fire. He was verbally warned several times, and there was an attempt to stop him until it proved unsuccessful and he was shot dead by the police. Van Spronsen is believed to be involved in previous run-ins with the law. In 2018, he was reportedly among 10 people to be taken by police and arrested on suspicion of a third-degree assault for jumping on the back of a police officer as he attempted to apprehend another suspect. Now, I believe this guy is probably mentally ill and maybe tried to kill himself through suicide by cop. I think he is the first of many victims to this now violent, inciting rhetoric from the left. And it's a slow build-up, just like the frog in the cooking pot, and for once, it's actually a good case for the slippery slope argument. First of all, they change the definition of racism and invent something like hate speech, rendering any legitimate criticism you have towards any person of color engaging in identity politics to be useless. When you apply this new racism label to your opposition, you can now equate them to Nazis. You then proceed to say punching Nazis is okay, and while it's satisfying to see horrible people who are legitimately Nazis getting KO'd, it's not something we should preach as it's incitement to violence and it's completely illegal. And there's a reason for it, guys. Because when you justify violence against a terrible group like the Nazis, it's only a matter of time before the left takes advantage of such an opportunity to lump everybody into that Nazi category so they can be politically violent and morally justified by their side because they are, quote, punching Nazis. And that's how you get a case like Andy Ngo's, where you get an immigrant Vietnamese LGBT journalist who has all the right identities the left supposedly protects, gets assaulted and his equipment stolen because he holds the wrong political opinions. Some are more brazen about their incitement to violence, like Carlos Maza, who's an annoying crybaby quote-unquote reporter with a blue checkmark on Twitter. If you go to his page, you can see him actively call for left-wing people to milkshake the opposition so they would be humiliated and fear public organizing in the future. On a right-wing figure, that kind of tweet would get you banned to the shadow realm in a second. But when you carry the banner for the leftist tech companies, it's more than okay to incite violence, it's rather encouraged, and that's why you see Facebook coming out with a new guideline allowing people to send death threats to people who have been banned by Facebook and deemed harmful by the media. Who is also a part of the problem, by the way. It's been a couple of years now where you see the leftist media refusing to acknowledge that Antifa is a domestic terror group with extreme violent intent, completely hiding behind their name being anti-fascist, just like the Democratic Republic of Congo is democracy. After all of that being established, you have people like AOC riding that wave, equivocating detention centers to concentration camps. Concentration camps were places the Nazis rounded up political enemies and mostly Jewish people who were also German citizens so they can abuse them for cheap slave labor and later on kill them systemically. The detention centers hold people who try to commit a crime by illegally crossing the border, making a mockery of the rule of law and legal immigrants at the same time. When you say it's okay to punch a Nazi and then you proceed to compare ICE to DSS, you get people trying to attack ICE facilities while in their eyes being morally justified. If you look at Sean King's latest pinned tweet, you get the idea of what I'm talking about when I say incitement to violence. The tweet says, and I quote, "History has taught us that concentration camps should be liberated. We cannot and should not wait until 2020 with the hope that we defeat Trump to free these children. We should liberate them now by any means necessary." My latest for The Intercept. You can clearly see an active call for violence and more similar action to be committed against such facilities, and it's not surprising at all when it comes after Vox calls for the left to arm itself with weapons. That's how you get a militant Antifa guy like Van Sponsen who's grown into LARPing extremism. With the rhetoric, the left has convinced the upper middle class white kids that they are literally the American army storming the beaches of Normandy, while in reality, they are a jobless millennial who's feeling some hole in their soul that is there because a lack of purpose in their lives. Make no mistake, intersectionality is an atheistic religion, and you can see it when those people chant the same things while gathering publicly just to get the weird sense of community they are probably lacking. The leftist disease has already seeped too deep into academia, the media, and big tech companies, and it's almost everywhere you can look at. A lot of people looking into America could argue that it's the beginning of a socialist revolution where you have public figures and Congress members actively trying to dismantle patriotic symbols like the Betsy Ross flag, and you also have politicians like Ilhan Omar who sees everything in the US as problematic and bad. That's why you see the attempt to remove freedom of speech completely by inventing things like hate speech, which is not a thing, but is a great tool to stop legitimate criticism. At the end, it's only going to escalate further and further, and if legislation is not going to come down on tech companies allowing such behavior on their platforms, and some of them like Facebook allowing death threats to persona non gratas, it's going to end in a civil war. If free speech is not going to be cemented as an absolute right across every platform, including social media, and if fake news companies won't be reprimanded for deliberately spreading fake and sometimes libelous information, nothing is going to change. The only power that people have is voting someone who's a human hand grenade to fuck up the entire system like Donald Trump is, and from what it looks like, he has an easy win in 2020 as long as his base won't be as smug and assured like the left was in 2016. Anyway guys, that's the entire video. I'd love to hear your opinions in the comments below. Don't forget to drop a like and share this video, and if you want to watch more of my videos, make sure to subscribe and hit the notification bell so you won't miss any of the new videos coming to this channel. I'll see you in the next one.